found a Toys R Us. I don't know if they're going out of business here, so we're gonna go check it out. This does not look like they're going out of business. Wow. Disney costumes. So in the mall at Osaka Station, there's a Pokemon Center store. It's got the signs for Pokemon stuff. And the slime Pokeball. Which is like a shopping district that I guess has a bunch of American stores or something. But then it also has there a little Statue of Liberty. Now we are headed to Ameya Yokocho, which is another night market at Tobio, or at Tobi Kamara, it's in Tokyo. It's Friday night right now. Probably going to be more crowded than the other markets because the other times we were out there on weekdays. Whoa! That's pretty cool. There it is! Ameya Yokocho. So, I guess there's a lot of vendors and some stores. So we're gonna try to get dinner somewhere around here. So this place is known for dried fruit and nuts and selling cheap athletic wear apparently. And there's some pachinko. There's an owl here.
Which I Uno.
We just finished dinner, so now it's dark and everything's lit up. It looks so cool when it's lit up. Oh wow. So this is the mall where we ate dinner. And then Ameya Yokocho across the street. We're now in an electronics store. We're on the fourth floor, I think, which is calculators and stationery and electronic dictionaries. I guess laptops too. But yeah, there's a bunch of floors and each floor has different things on it. They have these big tablets that you can try out. So I drew a Kirby. Oh, and then this other guy was here. And it's really good at drawing. Okay. This is the top floor of that, or the top floor of that store. There's a bunch of toys here. There were some video games. There were backpacks. Oh wow. We got a bunch of model trains. Because trains are big here. Disney stuff. Oh, he's dancing Pokemon that we saw at the Pokemart store. Or Pokemon. Some model paints. And paint brushes. And models.
Hey, that's your hand. This is the shedding band.
Ooh, and then cute little things. Like Kirby. Kind of want them. Oh, and even more models. Wow. These things are dancing. They were playing the Imperial March earlier. So cool. Also, these like paper things are really neat. I guess you get packs. And then they come in different layers. Depends on the 3D thing like that. We're in Harajuku now. The which I think is known for people dressing up very colorfully. And there's more food and candy and stuff here. Alright, here's something called Sugar High. I guess we have a lot of candy here. Here's a store called Line Friends. So, Line is an app where you chat, and I guess it's really popular here. So, and they have little mascots, so I guess they sell merchandise. It's crazy. Now we're heading to Ginza, which is an upscale shopping district. And according to Wikipedia, it is one of the most expensive, elegant, and luxurious streets in the world. And apparently on weekends, in the afternoon, they close off the main street to cars, so that it's called like pedestrian heaven. So you just like walk along it. So we'll see. Yeah, so this must be the main street here. See how it's locked off? So we could just walk all along it. Okay, this street is blocked off, so now we can walk in the middle of the street. That's the other end. Wow. So there's a bunch of fancy stores and fancy coffee shops and stuff. And then just tables where people are just sitting in the middle of the street. That's cool. This is a department store. Got a bunch of high-end products. This building has a bunch of rotating mannequins in sync. We're now on the 9th floor of one of the buildings, and there's a garden here. It's nighttime now, and the lighting looks really cool. Here's another store that looks cool, Retro Game Camp. Looks like it has a bunch of old video game stuff. They have a bunch of old games. Kirby stuff. Wow. Bunch of old game cartridges. It's pretty cool. That lobby is a electronics store. It's like the big camera, which is the other electronics store we've gone to. It's so big. Okay, I guess this is like an everything store, not just electronics. There's like cosmetics and stuff. Okay, they have a bunch of stuff on different floors, like everything you'd ever need, basically. We're gonna go to the 3rd floor because that has games and toys. That's my favorite. We have the Nintendo Labo with the toys. They have some jigsaw puzzles here too. So I have this one. Really nice quality, and it's stained glass, and they sell frames here that I think are for the stained glass ones where it's clear on the back, but they're too big for me to take home, so I can't get it. Now we're in the mall area looking around at the different shops and restaurants. There was a shop that sold like flour and stuff and sold just pure gluten. Pretty cool. The fruit is really nice and really expensive in Japan. That melon is $100. And those mangoes are $150. USD. Whoa. These look a lot fancier than the Krispy Kreme I'm used to.
Soy chow.
There's a lot of different stalls with food. Here's some more expensive fruit. $135 mango. $200. What is that, honeydew?
$160 cherries, Andy.
$160 cherries. And by dollars, I mean US dollars. And then there's like some purse stores, some clothing stores. There was like a shoe store and a tie store. Oh, here's another shoe store. A kitchen store? Lots of different types of stores, and they're all like specialized to one thing, I think. Ooh, and a cards store. Or a stationery store. Ooh. Okay, we are now in Yokohama's Chinatown, which is the largest Chinatown in Asia. I think it's They have non-food shops too.
Yeah, they have these again.
Outside looks like a castle, and there's three stories, like going up the turrets. And there's like statues inside. This is really fancy.